You ready? Oh, I'm not going with you, Father. I have an appointment with Solomon at 9. Then I'll be at the bank.
All right. I'll take the car and send Quinn back for you.
That's fine, sir.
Have you seen Marion?
I haven't had a chance. I was planning to see her over the weekend.
Good. They'll give her a call today. I'm sure she's wondering what's happened to you. See you later.
Yes, sir.
Coffee, Mr. Eckhart?
Oh, no, 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 thank you. That's a young man.
What?
You're a young man. My mother tells me you have a young man.
He is only a friend.
Well, Mother says he comes to see you every Sunday.
Yes.
Would you tell him not to come next Sunday? Please. I'd like to take you to tea.
But, Mr. Paul,
I want to talk to you, Anna. I want to go somewhere and talk. We live under the same roof, but we never talk.
I work on Sundays.
My mother and father will be at the country house. I'm giving you the day off. Is that a yes? Done so much with your life.
I think I've done nothing.
Well, you've taken your life in your own hands. You come halfway across the world by yourself, learning a new language.
You live in Italy. You feel home in a place like this.
I've only been acted upon, Anna. I still live in the same house where I was born. I was sent to school. I was put into the family firm. Everything's been done for me.
You are very fortunate.
Now, you're the fortunate one. Thank you. You have courage, Anna. Milk?
Please. This is so good. Such beautiful music.
That's Mozart.
What?
Mozart. Started composing when he was only 8 years old.
8 years? Said he's a little baby.
Oh, he's a true musical genius, Hannah. Well, perhaps sometime you'll come to a concert with him.
I would like, but for me, this is a concert. How to thank you. I had a very nice day.
So did I.
Good day.
Oh, Anna. Anna, come with me. I want to show you something. The painting. Isn't she beautiful?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
It's my mother's favorite painting. I must have heard her say at least a dozen times it reminds her of you.
Me?
Well, yeah, of course. Neck. Skin. Perfect skin. An elegant woman like you, Anna. Work of art.
It's a beautiful painting.
I'd like to thank you for today.
You thank me?
I don't know when I had such a wonderful time.
I can still hear Mozart.
So can I.
Oh, it was very nice of Mrs. Lerner to allow me to stay to dinner with you.
Oh, yes.
I suppose when you're rich, it's easy to be generous. Are you all right?
Me? I'm fine.
You're so quiet.
Oh.
You heard about that fire?
What fire? What fire?
No, the Triangle Shirtwaist Company burned down. It was 140 needleworkers that died. That's all anybody talks about. Don't you read the newspapers? Do they work you here so hard now you have no time to read?
Read other things, Joseph.
What kind of books?
Books.
Well, what books?
Books that Mr. Paul let me borrow from his library. Yesterday, I read a whole book about Italy. Italy is this close to Poland. And I never even knew. I heard Mr. Paul tell his father that if he was born again, he would like to be born in Italy. So I asked him if there's something I could read about Italy, and he gave me one of his very own books.
So you'd rather be born in Italy than in America? Yeah.
Oh, Joseph, it is a beautiful country.
Why doesn't he move there? You say he can get along without him.
You do not even know.
Oh, talk like that makes me angry. People live in a house like, I'm sorry, they don't appreciate this country.
Well, maybe he takes this country for granted. Maybe he takes America for granted. This house.
I hope they will come when my children will be able to take that for granted. And I hope they have a little feeling for the father and the country they came.